Hello, I made some textures for our boots, and now we're moving on to pants. Pants are always fun because you basically just clone the portion of the body that you plan to put pants on. I think that looks about right. Make sure that we got all the verts. We did. And Shift D will clone it, and then you can use P to punch it away. But in order for those pants to work out, we actually have to delete most of the body beneath the pants, which would look like this. This. So now we've got the pants that overlap slightly, but there's no longer any leg mesh, and that's really useful because it allows us to not have to worry about pop through. We can have these pants be fairly skin tight without any problems. In fact, we could just call this pants. However, if we look at our design, there is a little bit of decoration and there are some wrinkles. We're not actually going to put in all of the wrinkles, but let's go ahead and put in the decoration at least. So in order to create decorations, you have a lot of basic options, and in this case, I think we're just going to go with a texture map. So let's take a look at our textures. And we can see that if we were going to do that, our pants are not a mirrored texture. They are all in one unit. So what we're going to end up doing here is we're going to delete the left half of our pants. Goodbye, pants. And we're going to grab all this here. Don't forget that guy. Delete. And we can add in a mirror modifier, like so, to see what our pants will look like. Let's go ahead and just modify this out just a touch, and then E and bring it in. And that'll give us a little bit of pants sort of feel. Let's bring our clipping into effect and bring this guy under control again. There we go. And now, when we want to do our side UV, we can see that the pants have a specific setup. Hello. The pants have a specific setup, and that will allow us to create decorations on the side. Let's go ahead and do this our way, and that means we're going to take this and this. Is that a good set of lines? This and this. We're going to take these two and we're going to mark them. Mark the seams. And then we're also going to go ahead and mark a seam here because that's where a seam actually is. So mark the seam there. This seam automatically gets marked because it's the edge of the mesh. And then when we hit unwrap, we get this design here. And that's more or less suitable, although I would be happier if it was rotated 90 degrees this direction. You can see that we have a little bit of falling off. So in order to bring that in line, let's just drag it up. And it looks like this guy over here needs to be shrunk a little bit. So shrink Y. Squeak. That'll work. And now we have pants, front leg, back leg, and the line that we're going to decorate. Now, in terms of what we want the pants to look like here with buttons and stuff, we don't really have any particular interest in making it complex because we're going to have a tunic over it, and we're also going to have a big ass belt over the tunic. So we could add a lot of decorations up here near the waist where the pants actually would get complicated, but there's really no point. In fact, this is a good enough pants. The only issue here is that there's no wrinkles on this pants. But we can also paint those wrinkles in our texture if we would like. So it's up to us how we want to approach this. For now, let's go ahead and take these UVs and export them as our AnHero pants. Pants UV. Now, if we open up our image editor of choice, we can pull those pants UV in, like pants UV. Here they are. And you can see what they look like in our image editor. Now, yeah, let's pull over our favorite drawing piece of equipment, the tablet. Textures are actually very annoying to do without a tablet, so if you do plan to do textures, I recommend that you get a tablet. Bamboo is a fairly cheap tablet. That's the entry-level Wacom tablet. And you can get a Bamboo used for far less than it costs. And I think it costs $60 new, and it's cheaper than that used. They work quite well, so if you can afford that, that would be a good choice. Now, what color do we want these pants to be? I don't have any color designated here. We've got a sort of brown boots, and I was thinking that it would be best to have some kind of tan or brown top, so we can go a little bit crazy with these pants. Let's go ahead and make them bright red. Lincoln red. Or Lincoln green, I guess, is what it's supposed to be, but red is good. Now, we're not going to leave it red like that because we need a little bit of pattern. So let's go ahead and bring in some darker shades here, like this, and or rather some less aggressive shades here, and then we can just brush them in. And this brush is, I don't even think you can see this on YouTube, but it's giving us a very gentle grain to our pants. Now we can go and add in some wrinkles if we would like, but I'm not going to add them in here. This is our diffuse map, so there's no reason to have wrinkles in our diffuse map. But we do want to have our bindings and our little lacings up the side of our pants, which we're just going to make X's. We can be as complex as we would like with these. As I recall, this was actually pretty far forward, and the point was we were going to go something like this. Come on. No. And then we can bring the other way. Now, obviously, this is a very, very primitive setup, but it'll do for now. So this is not the greatest of hashes, and if you would like, you can spend roughly forever detailing it. We could put in holes for our loops and all sorts of aggressive details, but we're not going to bother for now. Right now, this will do. So we're going to go ahead and turn off the overlay. And we're going to save this. Rather than as pants UV, we're going to save it over in our materials as pants diffuse. That should have been a capital D, but whatever. So if we were to go back into Unity and wait a second for Anne Hero to... She's not catching up. Did we forget to save? Save. Grind, 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 grind. There we are, pants. So obviously that's not a very good pants material. Let's duplicate this boot material. We'll call it the pants material. Later on we will go ahead and make a an atlas. And we won't have all of these different materials, but for now these materials are fine. You can see that that's not exactly what we would like our pants to look like, although it looks kind of interesting, I suppose. So we'll take this pants diffuse map and drop it in. And that is more or less correct. We don't want any specular map. We don't need any white light mapping. We don't need any gloss. There we go. That gives us really shiny pants, doesn't it? Let's go ahead and change this shader out. We don't need the shader like that. Let's just go for a bump diffuse. And then we will drop our pants in again. Pants diffuse. There we are. And that gives us a pretty basic pants. But there is no feeling that we have a normal map going here. Let's go ahead and go back into our editor, which is... here it is. And save this as pants normal. Go back into Unity, find pants normal, make it into a normal map, bring this way down, and then we can drop that into the normal map section. There we go. So what we have here is pants that have a grain to them. The normal map would be ideal for use here, but you can see how it's actually backwards and the black is indented rather than extruded. So to deal with that, what we are going to do is we're going to go back into our pants editor here, and we are going to invert this black region. And the way we do that is by duplicating it, because we don't want to screw that up. And then we just lock this transparency and we just paint it white. We also want to paint in some wrinkles, so let's go ahead and grab our tablet and paint in some very gentle wrinkles. The best way to paint in gentle wrinkles is to just reduce the transparency down so you don't screw that up. I'm going to use a strong brush like this, and what we're going to do is we're just going to draw in some alternating light and dark lines. So here's the light lines. So this is the back of the leg here, which has a strong set of compression wrinkles like this. And then of course we've got wrinkles across the knee here, and we've got wrinkles out over here. We've got wrinkles running here and here. And of course down here. And now we can go black. Put these in. Oh good, someone started shouting outside. Now I don't believe that this is how masters make their textures, but it's a quick way to make textures, and we're developing at a breakneck speed, so it's good enough for our purposes at the moment. Now we just turn this off. And we can now save that as pants normal. And now you can see that the laces are very, very dark, but you can tell by the lights that they are raised up rather than put down. We can do all sorts of work with that later if we would like. The seam is really pretty obvious, and we can really do a lot of work adjusting that and making it look good right later on. But you can see that the wrinkles actually look pretty decent. The seam on the leg is the major problem, and that's not a big problem for me. I can leave it like that without any issues. So now we have made pants. These are super basic pants, which are literally just a leg clone. They're just the leg with stuff painted on it. And I hope that you have learned how to do a leg with stuff painted on it. Thank you.